started my career as a jeweler, I was 17, and I was going to the university in America, and I met a jeweler. His name was James C. Meyer, and he had a huge influence on my work because he, though he was a fine jeweler, and he encouraged the use of precious materials, which is what I do. I mix the materials a lot. You might have a gold ring that has something like a Murano crystal. I went to Italy. I was almost 21, and I went to assist him, and then I became one of his head teachers. So I was teaching goldsmithing. But while I was teaching, I was also learning Florentine technique. My passion for jewelry was definitely stronger, strangely enough, over the years. The two, I wouldn't call them careers, I mean, definitely my jewelry making is my career, but the modeling and what have you, it continued to little by little roll out, but it was definitely not my first concern. I believe in the power of jewelry as symbol also, and it's probably the most intimate thing that you can actually wear. I'm inspired by the world around me. This ring is called the petting ring, and it really is a body-inspired piece. It forces the thumb and the forefinger to close on itself to make the gesture, which in yoga and meditation is known as the kimudra. It has that purpose, which is in a certain sense a spiritual purpose, but it also has maybe even more of a spiritual purpose, because it's actually designed also for pleasing a man. I have a tendency to mix precious and non-precious materials, and feathers are surprisingly resistant, actually. And this is a cocktail ring, which can be worn out of the boudoir, but it also is very sweet in the boudoir as well. You can spray it with a little perfume, if you like.
So we are between Bastille and Saint-Paul, where my studio is, and well, there's a big motorcycle manifestation. So there's lots of boys in leather and motorcycles, Harley and company, and it's quite wild. This area is actually famous for that. Most manifestations, or mani as they call them in French, also start from my backyard.
Well, I think that if I had to have a real sort of icon, one would be Marlene Dietrich and Marquesa Luisa Casati, because they were both women of a very unique nature, and they had their own style. Fashion is an expression. It's definitely a representation of the way that we feel. If you're feeling more sort of serious and sober, you're definitely going to wear something sort of black, probably. I wear a lot of black. It redefines the body. Fashion is also a symbol of the times. We look through time. Things happen really fast now, but you can see something from the 80s, the 70s, to the 90s even, although fashion started to become everything goes, which is actually kind of exciting. Well, I have a part of my life that is also about staying fit, and I have a disguise that I wear to go and do my walks. I do a speed walk, probably average about 50 kilometers per week. And that's sort of my sanity somehow or another. So I do have a very comfortable selection of yoga clothes, basically, and soft cotton, and I put my hair under a hat and I go. It's important to be able to dress up. The turning point in my career was, well, I guess there are two turning points. In the early 90s, I began to work within the fashion system, and I was selling a series of objects which I considered wearable temples. So they were conversation pieces. They often had a spiritual pulse. My objects are definitely part of my path, part of my key. I realized quite early on that the two big taboos were pleasure. Pleasure taboo. It wasn't sex anymore, and it still is not sex anymore. I mean, sex is everywhere. My mission became to dismantle the pleasure taboo and diffuse sexual information and bring people who love each other to love each other better.